When I returned to Parsifal, it was very interesting for me because my ideas have not changed about the piece because I looked at it very carefully when I was first committed to it, to conduct it. But I mean, then I saw that was so important to have the texture, the continuous texture, and the kind of flow of the music, which can be expanded at some times because on the most important words or phrases. And then after that, when Gourneman speaks, you can go further without rushing, but I mean, giving to the music this kind of permanent continuity. And, you know, certainly I do that, I suppose, better than before because I am much more aware as a composer also of that.
It had been in 1966 with this opera, Wagner's Parsifal, that Pierre Boulez had first conducted at the Shrine of Wagner, the Bayreuth Festspielhaus. This performance was recorded in 1971, and 5 years later, Boulez conducted his first ring cycle of Wagner at Bayreuth. For the liner notes of the recording of the ring cycle that he conducted there in 1979 and 1980, he himself wrote, "The ring demands variety of expression, often involving exceptional agility, brilliance, and clarity. The myth of Wagner's stodginess is constantly contradicted by the imaginative way he deploys and distributes tone colors and divides the sections of instruments. Some of my problems at Bayreuth were to come from taking care over clarity, balance, and precision in the instrumental texture, graded levels of sound, exact rhythms, etc. Perhaps this is the composer in me reacting, but when I encounter writing which is so detailed and elaborate, I want to hear a resultant sound which matches the extreme precision of the original. Why would the composer have taken so much care over his score if all anyone is supposed to hear is a featureless mass? I cannot settle for a vague approximation, however excused by dramatic pressures." Both the radical production by Patrice Chéreau, updated to the Industrial Revolution, and also the qualities in Boulez's conducting that strikingly achieved what he wrote about in his liner notes, created a mini-scandal at the time. It was all so new to the Bayreuth audiences, who for so long had become used not only to the famous Wieland Wagner production, that itself had actually been very innovative when it was new, but also to a traditionally grand, bold, and generally spacious musical rendering of the score. The scandal was to be short-lived. Boulez and Chéreau were soon hailed as masters of Wagner's legendary ring cycle. Once again, Boulez had challenged convention, in the interests of the composer. As Pierre Boulez rose to worldwide fame as an acclaimed conductor of an extremely wide repertoire with the world's most prestigious orchestras and opera houses, he did have his detractors. They complained that his performances, for all their marvellous clarity and precision, could sound clinical and lacking in emotional expression, and most especially in music of composers of the Romantic era of the 19th century. In later years, they grudgingly had to accept.